You know, one thing that's always interested me, because I first heard your name the way and on the film that a lot of people did, which was Girl with the Pearl Earring. And I know that you had been a celebrated French composer before that, but I wondered, during those 50 French films, was your dream to go to Hollywood and you were hoping someone would hear you and bring you in, or was that an accident?
I think that secretly it was always a dream of becoming a Hollywood composer, yes. And many of my friends tell me now that I did mention it. I can't remember mentioning it, I mean, oralizing it. But I know that I was dreaming of that, because the scores that impressed me the most were from whether French composers who had flown to Hollywood, like Delery or Maurice Jarre, even Michel Legrand, or Hollywood composers like Herman, Waxman, and Goldsmith, and Williams. And even Nino Rota, who's maybe my favorite Italian composer for cinema, even Nino Rota, actually, he did The Godfather. So, yes, there was something about American cinema that was capturing my attention since I was a child. Don't forget that my parents were students in Berkeley, California, in the 50s, and they both spoke English together because my mother was Greek and my father was French. So it was their secret language. So as a child, I would hear as much English as Greek or French in the house. And they had many records. And in these records, there were many soundtracks. So I, as a child, I'm sure there's a very strong subconscious push for me to go to America.
Was there a score in that collection that stood out to you, a film score or a soundtrack?
Picnic, Cowboy, George Dunning.
Yeah.